Jazakallah, Brother Shaikh. Now we open the floor to question and answer session. Just very briefly, I would like to inform everyone what how the question answer session will proceed. We will first start from the ladies section.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Anal Bisharat, and my question is, with the reference to Surah Al-Qasas 28, 48 and 49 ayat, that it seems as if there are two books. Can you please clarify this?
Okay, have you got the Quran with you, please? Can you open this Quran? Surah Qasas 28 that you are referring to is 48 and ayah 49. I will read this and then we'll discuss. فَلَمَّا جَاهُمُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ عِنْدِنَا قَالُوا لَوْلَا أُوْتِيَ مِثْلَ مَا أُوْتِيَ مُوسَى أَوَلَمْ يَكْفُرُوا بِمَا أُوْتِيَ مُوسَى مِنْ قَبْلُ قَالُوا سِحْرَانَ تَظَاهَرَ وَقَالُوا إِنَّا بِكُلٍ كَافِرُونَ وَقَالُوا إِنَّا بِكُلٍ كَافِرُونَ قُلْ فَاتُوا بِكِتَابٍ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ هُوَ أَهْدَى مِنْهُمَا أَتَّبِعُهُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ When the truth came to them from our nearness, they said, why is not given similar as that was given to Musa, that is Moses, and they do not reject with what was given to Musa, and do they not reject with what was given to Musa, Moses from before? They said, these two are magics, backing each other. And they say, surely we are rejectors of both. So come with a book from the nearness of Allah, which is more in guidance from both of them. I would follow if you are truthful. Now, in this ayah, the ayat in the Arabic is referring to two books. So her question is that there in this ayah, there is two, what are those two books? So now I will read for you and you listen to me very carefully. When the truth came to them from our nearness, they said, people said, why is not given similar as that was given to Musa? This is a quotation Allah is quoting about the people. When the truth came to the people, for example, now at this moment, the truth that came to you to you now, just now, was that this book was given to all the prophets, right? Now we have just discussed that this book was given to all prophets. So Musa Islam got this book, right? But they are saying, why? Look, they said, why is not given similar as that was given to Musa, peace be upon him? So if we believe, as we have come to know, that Musa Salam got this book, all the prophet got this book, Muhammad Salam got this book, so it would be similar. So the people are objection is, why not given to Musa? Why was not given to Musa? They said, why is not given similar as that was given to Musa? So in their mind is this book. They are thinking that the Old Testament, the first five books, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, and Numbers and Deuteronomy, this was given to Musa as the Torah. So they are thinking in their mind that why is not given similar to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam this? In their mind is this book. So their objection is that why this is not given to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? We have come to know from this lecture that all the prophets got this book. But people, Allah says, those when the truth came to them from our nearness, they said, why is not given similar that was given to Musa? And Allah says, do they not reject what was given to Musa? What was given to Musa was this. What was given to Musa was this. So they are rejecting this. From before, they said these two are magics, backing each other. And they said, surely we are rejecter of both. One is I hold in my hand, or you hold in your hand, is a book. And you are verifying these ayahs. The other is what I am reciting. The other ayah is reciting, confirming that. The first I read the ayah. وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يُفْتَرَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَتَفْصِيلَ الْكِتَابِ Quran and the Kitab, there were two books. Quran is a confirmation of the book which you hold in your hand. So they become two magics. One is the recitation of the ayahs and one is the confirmation from the book. So these are backing each other. They are confirming each other. The ayahs that I recite and the ayahs you verify. So they said, in their mind is this book Bible. So they are saying, why is not this not given? Why they said, why is not given similar as to what was given to Musa? So Allah said, do they not reject with what was given to Musa? Meaning this was given to Musa, they are rejecting from before. They said these two are magic. What two magics? One is the recitation of the ayat, and one, this book was before, where you can confirm. So these are backing each other. They said, surely they are the rejecters of both. So surely we are the rejecters of both. So Allah says, so come with a kitab, book from the nearest of Allah, which is more in guidance for both of them. I follow if you are truthful. So remember, ladies and gentlemen, there are two books in a way. One is a book in front of you, where it is written down. And Quran, the reading is a confirmation of that book. In the lecture, in the beginning, I read an ayah. وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يُفْتَرَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيِّنَ يَدَهِ وَتَفْصِيلَ الْكِتَابِ. And Quran is not that can be produced other than Allah. It is a confirmation which is between your two hands and explanation of the book. So the book you read in front of you and one is recited, they are reading, is a confirmation. So these are two books. One is in front of you all the time, in all times. And one will be the revelation which will confirm the book that is in front of you. These two books will remain constant. They will not be in contradiction. So they say these two are magic. So Allah says, if these two are magic, you come a better book than these two. So they say, Allah says, so come with a kitab, a book from the nearness of Allah, which is more of guidance from both of them. One is the kitab for verification and one is the recitation from the book. This is the answer. Thank you.
Alaikum. My name is Mrs. Shara Wan. From the lecture, we have come to know that there has been one book in all times. My question is then, what is the status of Bible in the light of Quran?
Okay, this we have already know. We have listened to all this lecture. This book is one. So what is this book? How this books fit in the world? So if you open Surah, I refer to Surah Baqarah 2 and Ayah 79. فَوَيْلُ لِلَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ الْكِتَابَ بِأَيْدِهِمْ ثُمَّ يَقُولُونَ هَذَا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ لِيَشْتَرُوا بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا فَوَيْلُ لَهُمْ مِمَّا كَتَبَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَوَيْلُ لَهُمْ مِمَّا يَكْسِبُونَ. Then woe to those who write the book with their hands, and they say this is from the nearness of Allah, so that they purchase with it a little price. Then woe for them from what their hands do write, and woe for them for what they earn. Meaning there are people, this Bible, they are writing with their own hands. People have written in their own philosophies in the Bible, they're writing it, and they say this is from God. Bible is the word of God. Who's saying it? People. Bible is not saying any part of the Bible, there is not any verse in the Bible that this is from Allah. That in the Quran, many verses Allah said, we have sent down this book. هُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ. We have revealed this book. So the Bible never say this. They say, the people are saying this is the word of God. So Allah says, then woe to those who write with their hands and this the book, and they say this is from Allah. To traffic nearness from Allah, so to purchase with a little price. And then woe for them from what their hands do write, and woe for them what they earn. So the Quran ayat tells us, the Quranic ayat is telling us that this book, the Bible, is not from Allah, but people are writing it and trying to prove that this is from all. Actually, this is an imitation or a copy of the true book, Quran. There are narrations in the Quran which Bibles have them also. So actually, this is the truth, and Bible is an imitation of the Quran. Making stories nearest to, not exactly the same, but near enough. But of course, when you read and compare, there are a lot of differences there. The truth and falsehood, you can easily measure it out. But so that is the what status of Bible was never ever a book of Allah. We have read it that this book of Allah, all the prophets got. So that is the status of the Bible.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum.
My name is Sobia Aziz, and my question is, can you tell us that how many ayats are there that are muhkamat, that is governing? And how many ayats are there that are actually mutashabihat?
Okay.
That is similar.
Okay. How many ayats are we discussed the ayats. There are many muhkamat ayats and there are mutashabihat ayats. The governing ayats and the similar ayats, mutashabihat ayats. So how many number of these, for suppose these are the number, say 1,000 are the Mokam Ayat and the Sirri. There are 6,237 ayahs, and how can we divide them, that these are the Mokam Ayat or governing ayahs, and these are the Mutashabit or resembling ayahs? So your question is the number. So actually I have not counted them, because of the reason is that I will explain to you by example. You see, if you are reading the Quran, and when you are reading the Quran, there are governing ayahs, complete governing ayahs. You will read it and you will understand it. And I will give you an example. Suppose I read Al-Baqarah 2, I will read for you. You can note down the reference, or you want to check Al-Baqarah 2 and ayah 183. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyam kama kutiba alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. O you who believe, fasting is written over you as it was written on those before you, that you may be guarded. Now, if I read to you, if I ask all of you that this ayah, O you believe, that fasting is written over you as it was written on those before you, that you may be guarded. Is this ayah is narrating an event, or it is giving you a governing ayat? Sorry? Governing ayat. It is a governing ayat. Right? It's a governing ayat. So when we understand this is a one governing ayat, this is a governed, we have to govern ourselves, that means we have to fast. This is a governing ayat. Now another reference I give to you is another ayat, is Surah An-Naziat 79 and 15 to 20. هل أتاك حديث موسى إذ ناداه ربه بالواد المقدس طوى اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقل هل لك إلى أن تزكى وأهديك إلى ربك فتخشى فأراه الآية الكبرى. Has the event narration of Moses reached you when your Lord called to him in the sacred valley of folds? Go to Pharaoh, for surely he has transgressed all bounds. And say to him that you should justify, and that I guide you to your Lord, so that you should fear him. Then I showed him the great ayah, the sign. When you're reading this, what is it? Is it a governing ayat? It is narrating an event, a narration, a mutashabiyat or a similar ayat. Hal ataka hadithu Musa. Has the event or narration of Moses reached you? So it is an event. And this event is, you're reading an event. There is no governing ayat. There is no hukum here. It's an event. So this is hadith in that ayah. So this is the event. You can, so these are two ayahs. Okay. Now I read another reference to you. Baqarah 2, 185. Shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Qur'an hudal lin-nas wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal-furqan faman shahida minkumu sharaf al-yasumu. Ramadan is the month in which Al-Qur'an, the reading, is revealed as a guide for mankind and for the clarification from the guidance and from the criterion. So amongst you whosoever witnessed that month, then he should fast in it. Now I will read slowly and you have to analyze and answer me. Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed. Is it a governing ayat or an event? Event. Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed, mean Allah is narrating an event. Hudal linnas, a guidance for mankind, it is an event. Wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal furqan, and for the clarification and the guidance from the criterion. Faman shahida minkum ash-shahra falyasumu. So whosoever is witnessed that month, then he should fast. It is an event? No. So in one ayat, there is a governing ayat and an event also. In one ayat, there is a governing aspect and a event also. So in the whole Quran, there are ayahs. Some ayahs are mokam ayahs, governing ayahs, and some ayahs are eventful ayahs. And there are certain ayahs which contains both. And multi, in one ayah, two things, one governing, one event, and again governing and mutashabiha event. So you can easily understand that these ayahs are the governing ayahs, and then these are the eventful ayahs, and then they are a mixture of both. So in other words, exactly, I have not counted them, but when you read, you can classify this is a muhkam ayat, this is a governing ayat, and this is a mutashabihat hadith, eventful ayat, narration ayat. This is, you can understand. Thank you.
We all know that Quran is in Arabic language, and this book is for all time. Then my question is, what were the languages of the prophets, like Moses, like Jesus? What language they spoke?
Okay, actually this, we have just now read that the book is, we are talking about reading the book again, and this is all Arabic we are reading, this book. If this book was the same in all time, so this becomes the Arabic language. But your question is, what was the language of the prophets? That is the question, what was the language? Because in the Christian world, according to the Bible and Moses, they spoke Hebrew. Jesus spoke Hebrew and Moses spoke Hebrew. According to the Jews and Christians, this is what they say. But when we read in the ayahs, the Quran says, وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَىٰ يَا قَوْمِ, and Allah says, when Musa said, O my people, so Allah is not translating Hebrew into Arabic. Allah is translating about the Musa in Arabic. And when Isa says, وَإِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا إِسَىٰ, no, when he says, وَإِذْ قَالَ إِسَىٰ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ, يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ, so we, Isa Islam is speaking in Arabic. So Musa Islam is speaking in Arabic. Nuh Islam is speaking in Arabic in the ayahs. So Allah is not translating them into Arabic and giving us the book. So all the messengers was speaking Arabic according to ayahs. But now what has happened, first I will explain to you what, there is a different topic about languages also, but in, I will explain to you 2-3 ayahs to explain to you how the message was explained in the world, even there were different languages. First of all, our room 30 and ayah 22. The ayah says, وَمِنْ آيَاتِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْعَالِمِينَ. And from his ayah, sign is the creation of the skies and the earth, and the difference of your languages and your colors. Surely in that are ayahs, signs for those who know. So in this ayat, Allah is saying that Allah has created different languages and different colors. These are the signs or the ayahs of Allah. So there is nobody in the whole world who can claim that I created Urdu language, or I am the creator of English language, or I am the creator of any other language. So it is the ayahs or the sign that we people have different colors, white, black, yellow, whatever colors, and different languages of the world are the signs or the eyes of Allah. So that means all the languages, including Arabic, is all Allah has created the languages. So nobody can own or nobody can say he is the author of a different language. So all languages are by Allah's creation, and Allah's languages and colors are Allah's ayah signs. Now the revelation that came to us in Arabic is mentioned in Surah, other places, but I'm giving one reference, Ashura 26, 192 to 196. وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِرُ الْعَمِينَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنْ الْمُنْزَرِينَ بِلِسَانٍ عَرَبِيٍّ مُبِينَ وَإِنَّهُ لَفِي زُبْرِ الْأَوَّلِينَ. And surely it is a revelation from the Lord of the worlds. Revealed with it is the spirit of truth. Over your heart, so you become from the warners, with the clear Arabic tongue, Arabic language, and surely it is in the earlier pieces. Now in this ayat, if you will note, that Allah says that the revelation that came down is from the Lord of the worlds. Revealed with is the spirit of truth. Nazala bihirul amin. Ala qalbika, over your heart. Litakuna min al-muzdeen, so that you may mourn. That is referring to Muhammad Rasulullah. Bilisanin Arabi mubin, with the Arabic language. So that means the revelation that came to the messengers was with the Arabic language on the heart of messenger, Muhammad Rasulullah, that is in Arabic language. But to explain to the people, it is referred in Surah Ibrahim 14 and Ayah 4. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ فَيُضِلُّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. We have not sent from any messenger except with the language of his people in order to clarify for them. So Allah leaves training those whom he pleases and guide those whom he pleases. And he is exalted and power full of wisdom. In this ayat, Allah is telling us that Allah has sent messengers. We have read all these ayat, Allah sent messengers and they were all speaking in Arabic language. But to clarify it to the people, it is in the language of the people. So he says, we have not sent from the messenger except with the language of his people. So the messenger knew the language of the people. The revelation that came down was Arabic. We just now read with the Arabic language. But they also knew the language of the people. So the messenger explained people in the language of the people. And today also, the practice in the whole world is, whether now I am speaking in English with you. Right now I am speaking in English. But at the same time, this ayat is in Arabic, translated in English. And the explanation is in English. So all of parts in Urdu also, maybe in German also, somebody will maybe explain in German language, somebody is explaining Chinese language, or somebody is explaining any other language. So in all time, the messengers has been explaining people in the people's language. And people in this today world, we people are following the example and the footsteps of the messenger by trying to understand first the Arabic text and then translate and explain to the people in the language of the people. So all the time the message is understood by people in their own language. If I am using at the moment the medium English, so people are understanding, who knows understand English. So medium of the language is not a barrier, because Allah has said the languages and the color are made by man. Are made by Allah, or the ayahs, it's an ayat. The color and the language are the signs of Allah, are the ayahs of Allah. And the messengers that were coming, they were explaining people in the language of the people in all times. So your question, even if they were speaking, if suppose they were speaking Aramaic or Hebrew at the time of Moses and Jesus, but the message they were receiving was the book was Arabic. But explaining to the people, maybe in Aramaic or Hebrew, if it was so, whatever the language at that time was. According to, even today also, if there is a person in Jerusalem, he understands Quran in Arabic. He also speaks Jewish Aramaic language or Hebrew language. So he will read the ayat in Arabic and explain the Jewish people in the Hebrew language today also. You see, so if you understand now, you can understand how it happened in the past. So it is all time this is going on. The people are reciting the Arabic language, translating into the language of the people, explaining these people in all languages of the world. And these are the ayah signs of Allah, the ayah said themselves.
Right. Al-Baqarah 2.
Yes, please, in English,
when
please.
When the Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam is raising the foundation of Kaaba,
yes,
so they are reciting a dua, you see. You have referred this dua to Hazrat Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Prophet Muhammad. My question is, why not Musa alayhi salam, why not Isa alayhi salam, why this is attributed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Because he, as to our knowledge, he was at the end, the last chain of the prophets, you see, number one. Second question is, if this is the book given to all the prophets, you see, so what was the order of revelation, you see? Because again, the question of era jumps in, according to our limited knowledge, you see, what we have understood, that Ibrahim alayhi salam, then Musa alayhi salam, then Isa alayhi salam, then many prophets in between. The last chain of the prophets is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is my question. You got my question, sir?
Yes, okay. First of all, your question is that why when the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ismail alayhi salam is asking for a messenger, Rabbana wa waathim rasulam minhum yatlu alayhim ayatika, that ayat. How can we understand that this messenger is Muhammad Rasulullah? Why not the other messengers?
Why
we would understand? Because we understand that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the seal of the prophets, which you refer to as end. So Muhammad Rasulullah is a messenger of Allah and the seal of the prophets. So that Rasul, if it was with Musa, suppose we say Musa, then after Musa is Isa. So if that dua could have not been completed, if because there was another messenger coming after Musa was Isa. So and if that messenger, that Rasul, if Ibrahim Islam, Ismail Islam prayed for any messenger, so that means you are not believing after him the other messengers. So it should be the messenger that he is the seal of the Prophet, that messenger, that is why we all the scholars have agreed upon and we understand that is Muhammad Rasulullah as the seal of the Prophet. Like for example, if I say La ilaha illallah, Isa Rasulullah, that there is no God but Allah and Isa is the messenger of Allah, this is right. If I say La ilaha illallah, Musa Rasulullah, there is no God but Muhammad, Musa is the Rasulullah. But if I stick to that, it will not be a complete, because after Musa is Isa. But if I say La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah wa Khatam al-Nabin, that means now I am saying about Muhammad Rasulullah is the seal of the Prophet, that means he is including all the Prophets previous. So that means Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we believe that Ibrahim al-Islam or Ismail al-Islam prayed for that personality which will include all time. That is Muhammad Rasulullah, wa innaka la khuluqun azim, wa ma arsalnaka illa rahmatil alameen. We have not sent you as the mercy for all mankind. So Muhammad Rasulullah will include all the Prophets as the seal of the Prophets. That is why his name or that messenger is referred to Ibrahim al-Islam or Ismail al-Islam. Is not referring to a messenger which will limit to a particular era. But Muhammad Rasulullah as a seal of the Prophets is referred to all Rahmatul Alameen and a Khuluqul Azim, best of the character. So Ibrahim al-Islam or Ismail al-Islam, we understand, is praying for Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam because he is the seal of the Prophets. He includes all the Prophets. And even in our Salah, we say, even Azan, we say, Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, in our back of the mind, that he is the messenger of Allah and the seal of the Prophets. He is the messenger of Allah and the seal of the Prophets. That means no prophet you can add or subtract, because until he must have a Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam seal on him. But if you only say like Christians, suppose they rightly believe Isa is the messenger of Allah. Rightly, I said, meaning the right status, not as the son of God, not as the mother of God, rightly. So, but they are not believing the complete messenger, because after Isa Islam is Muhammad Rasulullah, because Isa Islam forecasted out Muhammad Rasulullah. So that is the answer for the first part of your question, that Ibrahim al-Islam or Ismail Islam has prayed to Allah as the only messenger, inverted commas, Muhammad Rasulullah is fitting because he is the seal of the Prophets. That means including all the Prophets within that his personality. The other question is, what is the order of revelation given to all? Because the book, if today you hold in your hand the book, it is, we have understood and we know that the order of revelation according to history and tradition is that chapter 96 Surah Alaq was the first chapter of order of revelation. And then was the other ayahs, and then this is how it was compiled and make into the book. So now we have to first analyze what is the order of revelation and how the revelation was given to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all time. Surah Al-Baqarah 2, ayah 23, first I read for you. وَإِن كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَأَتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِّن مِّثْلِ وَدُعُوا شُهَدَاكُمْ مِّن دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. And if you are in doubt as to what we have revealed on our servant, that is Muhammad Rasulullah, then come with a surah, a chapter, one surah, like it. And call your witnesses besides Allah if you are speaking the truth. So in this ayah, Allah says that if you are in doubt as to what we have revealed to our servant, then you come with a surah, chapter, one surah. The Arabic word is one surah. So this is ayah one surah you have to come. Now this is in Surah Al-Baqarah 2. Ayah Baqarah 2, he says come with one surah. But if you root in Surah Hud 11, Surah Hud 11 and ayah 13. Am yaquluna aftarah. قُلْ فَاتُوا بِعَشَرِ سُوَرٍ سُوَرٍ مِثْلِهِ مُفْتَرَيَاتٍ وَدْعُوا مَنِ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Or they say, he forged it, he invented, he produced it. Say, come with 10 surahs, chapters, forge unto it, and call whomsoever you can other than Allah if you are truthful. Now these are the two verses from the same book, right? And in Surah chapter 2, you have to give an answer, people, if anybody. In Baqarah 2, he says, come with one surah, if you are doubt. And in Surah Hud 11, 11 surahs, He says, come with 10 surahs. 1 minute. No, hold on.
You got it, brother.
You. In 10 surahs, 11 surahs, he says, come with 10 surahs. And in 2 surahs, he says, one surah. What do you understand by this?
Sequence.
In 11 surahs, Allah says, if you are in doubt, come with 10 surahs. And in 2nd surah, he says, come with 1 surah. Brother, understood? Excuse me, have you understood? That's what I'm repeating. Some people may have understood. Look, Allah is saying that people who are doubting, in this chapter 2 surah, in 2nd surah, he says, come with 1 surah, 1 chapter. When he reached 11th surah, he says, come with 10 surahs. So what do you understand? What is the sequence? What do you understand by this? No? You understand this? You understand the question? How the Quran was revealed? What is the order of the sequence of the surahs? How? How would be the same order? The same order will be in 2 surahs. 2nd surah, when Allah was talking in the 2nd surah, he said there is 1 surah before. So he said, come with 1 surah. And when he reached 11 surahs, he said, come with 10 surahs if you doubt. So that means he has given, that is the order of revelation. The question he was asking was, what is the order of revelation? So it was not the 96th surah was the first surah. The order of the Quran today as we see, in the 2nd surah is the 1 surah is asking for 1 surah, and in the 11th surah is asking for 10 surahs. That means this is the order of revelation. But we see at the same time that in history that it is recorded that there were situationally, Quran was revealed, situationally, according to this is Shan and Nuzul. A situation occurred, there was a situation and then ayat was explained. So it was according to, situationally also Quran was revealed. So according to that understanding, how will we understand? So Surah Al-Asra 17 and Ayah 106. وَقُرْآنًا فَرَقْنَاهُ لِتَقْرَاهُ عَلَى النَّاسِ عَلَى مُقْسِنْ وَنَزَّلْنَاهُ تَنْزِيلًا. And we have divided the Quran so that you read it on mankind on intervals or situationally. And we have revealed it revealing. So in this ayah says the Quran, Allah is divided. Quran is being divided by Allah into different surahs and chapters and in stages, in situations. For example, in Surah Al-Nahl 16:101, وَإِذَا بَدَّلْنَا آيَةً مَكَانَ آيَةً وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يُنَزِّلُ قَالُوا إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُفْتَرْ بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. When we change the place of ayah with an ayah, and Allah knows with what He reveals, they say, you have produced, invented, but majority of them do not know. Now, the Quran revelation, order of the Quranic revelation is the same as you see today. Surah Fatiha first, and Surah Baqarah 2, and Surah Hud 11, and Surah Nas last. But what has happened is, for example, you people have come to a lecture or a course that on a particular topic, particular subject, and that is about the book. In that context, we have to collect the data from different surahs and ayahs, collect the data, and then write at it. Then you understood what is the status of the book. Similarly, in all times, when Allah, this is what Allah says, وَإِذَا بَدَّلْنَا آيَةً مَكَانَ آيَةً. When Allah changed the place of an ayah with an ayah, Allah knows what has to be revealed. So they say He produced it. But the majority of do not know. What has happened in all times, whenever any topic has to be discussed, you have to collect the data and ayahs from different surahs and ayahs, put together and then expound. And then Allah has changed the place of an ayah with an ayah. It always do that. Allah always do this. The place of an ayah with an ayah. So that the Allah knows what has to be revealed. So you see, the booklet that has been given to you is not in the sequence of the Quran, the order of the Quran. Because we are not discussing the whole Quran. We are discussing a particular subject. And for that subject, we have to collect the ayahs together. But the placing of an ayah, exchanging the place of an ayah exchange is done by Allah. That is what Allah says, we have divided the Quran وَقُرْآنَ فَرَقْنَاهُ لِتَقْرَاهُ عَلَىٰ مُقْسِنْ عَلَىٰ النَّاسِ عَلَىٰ مُقْسِنْ وَنَزَّلْنَاهُ تَنزِيلًا. We have divided the Quran so that you read it on mankind at intervals in different situations. Similarly, وَإِذَا بَدَّلْنَا آيَةً مَكَانَ آيَةً وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يُنَزِّلْ قَالُوا إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُفْتَرٍ بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But when we change the place of an ayah with an ayah, Allah knows with what He reveals. They say, you have produced, invented, but the majority of them do not know. You follow what I'm saying? This is how the change of ayahs and intervals. But the Quran will remain as it is. On situations, on different subjects, we have to collect the ayahs data, and that is also permissible because Allah said, we are doing it, we are doing this. This is the answer of this.
JazakAllah, brother. We are ending our session today. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.